There are two NPCs that you can talk to start a fight against Flame Leviathan. One of them is Bran Bronzebeard and the other is Lorekeeper of Norgannon. Talking to the Lorekeeper will make this encounter harder and give the boss additional abilities. There are three vehicles that you can choose from and I prefer to use the Demolisher. You can also use the Siege Engine if you want, but I prefer to do it this way. The vehicles scale with your item level. The higher it is, the more health and damage they will have. Make your way to the end of the gauntlet. Along the way you'll see towers that spawn dwarves, but you can ignore them except for the last two towers. I can advise you to turn off your sound because the helicopters make a lot of noise when they attack you. Once you reach the end, you'll see two glowing platforms. Driving over these platforms will heal your vehicle and give you full energy or pyrite. Destroy the two towers, destroy the two spider robots, and make your way to the final trash. Killing the two giants guarding the door will make Flame Leviathan spawn, so if you want, repair before you kill them. Flame Leviathan in normal mode is very easy. Use the Demolisher to fight him. You will have 3 abilities and you'll need to rotate between number 2 and either number 1 or number 3. Shooting number 2 at Flame Leviathan will place a stacking dot on him to a maximum of 10 stacks. Simply use number 2, then number 1, then number 2 again, and if he's in melee range, rotate it with number 3. Do this until you've reached 10 stacks, and this should give you enough DPS to bring him down. Doing it in hard mode is a little bit different, because it increases Flame Leviathan's health, and it gives him a couple of extra abilities. You want to reset the fight, and do a couple of things before engaging him. Place the Demolisher at the opposite side of the room, place a siege engine and a chopper on the left, and another siege engine and a chopper on the right. You do this to buy yourself some time and to get some transportation to your second vehicle. Once those are set, it's time to fight, so enter your Demolisher and shoot at Flame Leviathan. The rotation is a little bit different, because now you'll start off with number 2 just as before, only you want to rotate it with two other abilities. This will increase the time that the dot is on Flame Leviathan, and this will increase your total DPS on him. So use number 2. Then use number 1 twice, then number 2 again, number 1 twice until he's in melee range, and then you can rotate between number 2, 3 and 1. Once he destroys your first Demolisher, jump on a chopper and ride to the second one. Repeat your rotation and finish him off. Like I said before, he will get a couple of extra abilities. He will summon plant adds, summon light beams that deals damage, fire from the sky, and a blue beam that will freeze you in ice. The main one to look out for is the freezing beam. If he catches you with it, it's game over, so keep moving away from it. There are a couple of achievements that you might be able to solo on this encounter. These are the following. Dwarvageddon, which requires you to destroy 100 Steel Force Defenders in 10 seconds. You can do this by grabbing one of the big tanks, drive to one of the platforms, and drive in circles until you have enough dwarves. AoE them down and you have the achievement. I have another video up that gives you a couple more details on this achievement. Unbroken, which requires you to defeat Flame Leviathan on the first try without anyone repairing their vehicle. You can do this by clearing everything up to the two giants who are guarding the door. After you've cleared everything, grab a new vehicle, kill the giants and kill Flame Leviathan. Just make sure to never drive over the glowing platforms. Free car garage, which requires you to defeat Flame Leviathan while in each of the following vehicles. Those are the three different vehicle types. Now, the demolisher and the siege engine should be easy enough. You can just jump in the siege engine near the end. The chopper, I never actually managed to do it myself, but I think it's possible. If you dot the boss up, you wait till he's around 10%, jump in the chopper and finish him off. Take out those threats isn't possible because it will require you to be launched on top of Flame Leviathan and you'll need a second person. A shutout is possible and it requires you to defeat Flame Leviathan without causing a system shutdown. Since you won't be able to launch on Flame Leviathan, this one comes automatically. Orbital bombardments, which requires you to defeat Flame Leviathan with at least one orbital defense system active on normal difficulty. You can get this one by killing Flame Leviathan in hard mode. I think this achievement upgrades the more orbital defense systems you'll keep alive. So if you follow this guide, you'll have four orbital defense systems online and you should get all four achievements. That's all the information I have for the Flame Leviathan fight. Good luck and until next time guys. See ya!